Be here. My name is Milena Krumova, and I just defended my PhD study last week, so I'm happy about that. Along with my supervisor Elena Shorkova, I will show you the results of my PhD study. What is the aim of this research paper? The aim is to accent on the competency-based education and to answer the question how we can improve the learning outcome, how can we motivate our students to study more engaging, to study more challenging, if I can say, to achieve more results and to think more seriously about their career development, and how we can do that by using the technologies that are a lot of nowadays, and how to engage them in attractive learning scenarios. The accent on the study is also on the agenda of Europe 2020. These are, in a short, the topics that I will discuss now. First of all, I will share with you the definitions about the competition. Competency, because there are a lot of definitions, but I think that the one that we can rely on is the definitions about the competency of European qualification frameworks that accent on the learning outcome, which is proved by learning artifacts. So the students are achieve their learning outcomes based on something that is visible, something that is readable, and different, if I can say, digital resources. This is an abstraction process of the competency. So something that is really important in that abstraction is the outcome of the learning process. Here we can see the relation among the learner, the relation among the competencies, and the relations among learning scenarios. There are different, if I can say, resources which we can rely on in order to develop engaging learning scenario. And among those resources are the dictionaries for competencies. One of the well-known globally is the WorkiDEC, where the competencies are structured into three groups. The first group is related to people, the second one is related to business, and the third one is related with self-management. Here we will share with you in a little bit details about thinking conceptually. What is the definitions about thinking conceptually? It is something to find an effective decisions about doing our activities in everyday life, doing our activities in our job, and if we would like to assess if the student, if the students have achieved that competencies, we can use different behavior indicators in order to see if they achieve that or not. So these are the five basics, if I can say, behavior indicators in order to evaluate if that student think conceptually. And one of that is that he or she notice something in common between different things, and that is obviously. Another one is a behavior, if you would like to assess that, is to achieve if he or she very fast can identify central or key questions in any complex situations. The other thing that we have presented is the link between curriculum, the link between a course program, and the link between learning scenarios, which can be viewed as a learning objects. In a study, we have analyzed some, if I can say, benchmark practices globally in the United States, in Europe, and very achieving best practices, if I can say, in Australia. Among benchmark practices in Europe is the University of Karlsruhe, where they are applying competency-based educations, and the results are great. Another model that we have analyzed is the model of Western Governor University in the United States, where we see the integration of innovative technologies during the process of study. We have also accent on what are the tendencies related to competency-based education, and we can see four of them. This is the personalized environment for the student to study. This is also collaborations among students and learning communities. It is also informal learning and non-formal learning, which I will prove at the end of presentation that is a key for a better learning process. And also how to create new knowledge and how to share that new knowledge among learning communities. Something that is really keen in studying questions related to education is how Web 2.0 applications can grab the mind of learners. And nowadays, a very hot topic in learning is Learning 3.0. This is for some university current situation, but I think that in the future we will talk more often about that. We know that there are a lot of Web 2.0 applications nowadays. They are to some extent results of the coming open data realities, and most of them or many of them can be used at no cost, and for educational purposes they can be used with more functionalities. We have developed a model for developing innovative learning scenario, and we accent on the learning activities, the student reading, researching, presenting, thinking, analyzing, and we try to answer how those learning activities can be boosted by using applications. This is a model who answered the questions to some extent related to the model of Nonaka Itakiuchi for knowledge creations, which model you know that have been developed in 1995. So we try to explain the interaction between tacit and explicit knowledge and how different technologies can be implemented for that purpose. We developed also a model for a system methodology for design of learning of curriculum. And also innovative model for explaining how individual indicators for behavior are linked to the curriculum. This is the developed innovative learning scenario with integration of IMS learning design, with integration of Bloom taxonomy for knowledge creation and the model of Nonaka Itakiuchi. Something that is pure in the model is that we create an added value by using it and apply it in a real practical environment. This is developed a semantic concept model of scenario 2.0. And we have also analyzed many different applications, for example, Animoto, which is animation, which is applications for developing interactive multimedia. Quiz Creator, which is applications for assessment. Screener is an application for developing screencast at no cost. Prezi is an application you know for dynamic multimedia. SurveyMonkey is an application for electronic assessment. Voki is wonderful because it allows to students for 1 minute to create a speaking avatar based on their choosing for their outlooks. Also, Flip Snacks in an applications for developing, if I can say, a lively book. and many more which we have applied it in real learning environment. These are that are presented in that slide are digital resources developed by the students. At the end of the PhD study for the last 4 years, the all number of the students who have participated in that scenarios numbers on 743, and the tool that we have used is PBWorks, which is cloud-based platform, which can be used for educational purposes at no cost. It is developed by the United States, and also extremely valuable is the open source ILIAS 4.3, the last version of the learning management system, which is developed in Germany. Also, some of the students worked with Tumblr. This is a block approach for implementing learning scenarios. It is really interesting also web-based platform at Modo, in which it is integrated an electronic portfolio. At the end of the study, we have conducted something that is accepted as a best practice globally, to ask students, what do you think about that? What do you think about that innovative model of learning? And the outcomes are wonderful. Most of the students are very pleased about that model. They think that those results prove that that model enhanced their motivation, that this model developed their digital competencies, which is one of the competencies in the key qualification framework of the European Union. And also that those models gives an opportunity to develop skills for self-learning, that most of the students studied about Web 2.0 for the first time. This is something new about them. We have conducted a feedback analysis at the end of the second year of the implementation of developed learning scenarios. And something that is really interesting is that what the students think about themselves, and that they think very positively about them. Something that, and I'm finishing my talking, something that is really interesting also on the question, which of the applications that we have used at our classes is most interesting about you? As you can see, most interesting for the students is Animoto. I think that one of the reasons is because in Animoto they integrate their favorite music, and I think that music is a very effective tool in order to boost our students to study more engaging, to study towards creating more better results, and to engage them in order to think professionally. The results at the end of the study are proving the initial statement that while integrating innovative tools and technologies in learning, we can boost our students to be engaged, to be motivated, and to develop their creative skills. If you have any questions, I will be happy to answer, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Ms. Gromova, for this very informative speech. The good news for all of us, that we will have all presentations in the website of the UNESCO chair. Also, we have a record, and finally we will have a proceeding. So this all interesting speeches, we will have a chance to follow up and to see more deeply. Thank you to Milena. Questions? Yes, please.
A small comment. I find the blog approach really valuable for certain types of projects, especially those which can benefit for bigger community interest or that can welcome a community input, for example, data gathering and so on. This is something that works really well for certain types of projects. One small question of all platforms, why Tumblr?
Thanks. Thanks for the question. Actually, I use it not on the basis of any comparative analysis, but because I find it as a best practice as a result of NASA Space Apps Challenge event, which recommended it as a good tool. So I rely on that recommendation and use it in my classes. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Ada? Please.
So if you allow me a short remark, you noted avatars and you made some avatars training systems. Is there a capability here to implement other languages than English?
Mm-hmm.
And what's your impressions about the kids' interest about such kind of systems, especially on things like internet of smart devices?
Mm-hmm.
Because nowadays the new generation is working on that screen, so this will be the targeted audience. Thank you.
Thank you for the question. Most of the tools are obviously in English, but I think that our students can understand it, very easy English. And most of the tools that I used, we can write in them and use them writing in Kyrillic. So, for example, the application Voki, which I apply in my classes in order to give them assignment. In Voki, the students can speak in Bulgarian, so it allows another language than English. But if you allow me to add something interesting, that the assignment that I give to students is that one. I tell them, please read the lecture of the lecturer, then resume the lecture in 1 minute. After that, create your avatar and how you prefer yourself to look like. Then please record this 1 minute resume through the avatar and upload those digital resources in the platform PBWorks. So the interesting things are that the students first read the lecture, then resume the lecture, then record the lecture, then listening the lecture, then they sometimes are interested in the assignments that their colleagues are done and again listening that materials, and at the end of performing that assignment, actually without no efforts, they know the lecture that they actually have to know. And the other assignment is, for example, to develop an electronic survey based on the surveying tool. Then they have to read another lecture, to develop questions, and to share that questions with another colleague. So all the tools allow to write in Kyrillic and to use Bulgarian language.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you.